Hello everyone, my name is Adam Commander. I'm a fitness instructor at 19 Wing Comox. We're going to be doing a flexibility session including static stretching, dowel stretching, and foam rolling. The equipment you'll need today is one band, one dowel or a thin piece of piping, and one foam roller as well as a mat and any other things you might need for this. I'll be linking a disclosure down below and also showing it on the screen. We encourage you to read it prior to this session. And we encourage you to subscribe to our channel to get up-to-date videos on workouts every single day. So first up, we're going to be doing a warm-up. We'll be doing each exercise for 30 seconds. First one will be squats, then a plank, then a side lunge, followed by butt kicks and arm circles. And this is just to get the body warmed up for the flexibility session, get the blood pumping a little bit, so that way we can work a little bit more with more muscles. So first up, we'll do squats. And this is just air squats for 30 seconds. Going into the session, I'll show you each flexibility exercise right before we do it. I won't show them before as a big group. So that way you can get an idea of what we're doing, and we'll have a little bit of a rest session between each exercise. Make sure you're getting a nice 90 degree angle, keeping the back straight. All right, shake it out. Next up, we'll be going into a plank, just a 30 second plank, nothing big. In 3, 2, 1, and up. Make sure you're keeping a nice neutral spine, keeping your butt not up, but down. Try not to let your hips sink to the floor. All right. It's important we do these warm-up exercises to get the muscles warm. If you try and stretch on cold muscles, you risk getting a torn muscle, pulling a muscle of any sort. So it's always better to do this warm, even though it is not a high intensity exercise or session. So next up, we'll be doing side lunges. We'll do 30 seconds total, standing up nice and tall, going from side to side, nice and tall, side to side. You're getting a nice bend in your knee. All right. Next up for our fourth or fifth warm-up exercises, we'll do butt kicks. So this is just in motion. Okay, and our last warm-up component will be arm circles. So we'll do 15 seconds forwards and then switch to backwards for the final 15 seconds. And go. And switch to backwards. Okay, so first of three we'll be doing today is a flexibility session. So this is going to be static stretching. We have 11 exercises or stretches on tap for today. This includes hamstring, quads, glute, lying torso, running lunge, thoracic stretch, shoulder, tricep, child's pose, cobra, and wrist. So each one we'll be doing for 25 seconds. Take about a 5 to 10 second rest in between just to switch positions. But you're gonna need a band for this first one for the hamstrings. So get your band out. You're gonna wrap it around the bottom of one of your feet, right in the middle, You're gonna lie down and pull the band behind your head, so you're pulling your legs straight up in the air back. You should feel a nice tension right in the back of your hamstring. You can pull more for more of a stretch, pull less for less, whatever feels comfortable. Hold that stretch. It's important to do a little longer stretch than you think, just because it does take a little while for that muscle to loosen up. A 10-second stretch won't do too much. It's better to do about 20 to 30 seconds. And switch legs. Reminder to keep your bottom leg nice and straight as well. And you can have a slight bend in your stretched leg. That way you're not putting too much strain on your hamstring. Next up, we'll be doing a quad stretch. You can do this seated as well. You're gonna grab one ankle, one leg straight out in front of you, and bring up behind you, and I'm just trying to sit on this side of the leg. Should feel this running down the front of your quad here. And if you have tight legs, you might feel it in your ankle, depending on how much flexion you have on your foot as well. So we'll go another 15 seconds here. Switch legs. Though boring, flexibility is one of the more beneficial sessions you can do for your body. A lot of people tend to skip it because they don't think it's going to be useful or it's boring to them, but flexibility can really make or break performances, especially if you're training in a high intensity type of sport or program. Flexibility can go a long ways and prevent injuries as well. And it can also increase range of motion and actually elevate your lifts or your performance, wherever that may be. All right, switch that leg back out, give them a little shake. Next up, we'll be doing a glute stretch. This will be on the back. What you're gonna do is put one ankle on your opposite knee, grab through, grab the knee, and bring it towards your body. You should feel this right in your glute back here. Hold this for 20 more seconds. Switch legs. You can also lean to your foot side to get a bigger stretch as well. Kind of leave your back on the ground. Just trying to roll your lower body down to the floor. Yeah, keep holding this position. All right, next up we'll also be on our back. This is gonna be the lying torso stretch. Actually, this will be on our stomach. You get on your stomach, so you're gonna bring one leg over, try and keep your chest on the ground, and you should feel this right in your lower back. So ground leg straight, upper leg, trying to go across the other side of your body, leaving your torso on the ground as much as you can. Hold this for 10 more seconds. And switch sides. Should feel this running all the way up your lower back. All right. And we'll back up on our knees, shake it out. Next up will be the runner's lunge stretch. So that's exactly how it sounds, except it'll be on your knees. Kind of form 90 degree angle on your front knee, and then just try and push forward. Try and push your front knee forward as much as you can. You should feel it right through your left hip if your right foot is forward, opposite for your left. We'll hold this stretch for another 20 seconds. Flexibility is something you can do almost any time as well. You know, you're sitting at home watching TV, Netflix, what have you, and you can do 10 minutes of easy stretching doing that without even thinking about it hardly. It's one of these things you can do at any point. Just switch legs here. It can be really beneficial, but it's also important not to overstretch. So stretching multiple times a day, holding positions for longer than you should. I would say the ideal, like I said before, 20 to 30 seconds for stretching is about all you need per side or muscle. Reminder to keep pushing forward, really trying to stretch out your hip, back hip there. All right, next up, the sixth flexibility exercise we'll do is a thoracic reach through. So again, another lower back. A lot of people have lower back issues, so this would be a good one. Gonna be on all fours to start. You're gonna bring one arm through the other, rest your arm on the ground, and just trying to flex your lower back. Should feel that stretching right through there. Really try and focus on bringing this arm through. Back up on all fours, go to the other side, and hold. Back up, good stretch, shake it out. Next up, we'll be doing a shoulder stretch. You can either do this standing or to stand your knees like I am here. Just gonna bring one arm across your body, grab the opposite shoulder with the hand, and just try and pull it towards your body. It's a good reminder to really focus on your breathing on these exercises as well. You can get caught up holding your breath. Different type of breathing techniques, but it's always better to take nice deep breaths, and as you breathe out, try and get even deeper into the stretch. Switch sides. Shake it out. Next up, we'll do a tricep stretch so you can stay in the same position. Lifting one arm across over the top of your head. Grab the elbow and just try and push it down. You should feel that stretch right through your tricep. Keep holding that position there. Reminder to keep breathing, getting deeper into your stretches. Switch sides. hold the position. Good. Exercise 9 of 11 will be the child's pose. This will be another back stretch. So get on all fours again and just bend down towards your knees, leaving your arms extended in front of you. Focus on having a flat, neutral spine. Don't try and bend it. Really just try and focus on bringing it to the ground. And we're back up. Exercise 10 will be a cobra. This will stretch out your core. On your stomach to start. Hands beside you, trying to just lift yourself off of the ground. You should feel that right through your front abdominals. Hold the position. Good. Last flexibility exercise will be a wrist stretch. So you can stay on fours, stand up, or stay on your knees, or stand up, it's up to you. But you're gonna take your palm of your hand, rest it on the fingertips of the other, and then just try and push back. You should feel that stretching of your wrists, possibly your fingers. Good stretch for a lot of people that sit on their computers, do a lot of work there. Or people who generally just don't flex their wrists. So forgotten about part for sure. Good, switch sides. Okay, so that's part one of our session here. Next up, we'll grab our foam roller. We'll be doing 9 different exercises. We'll be holding them for 45 seconds each. The reason why you want to do these for a little bit longer than stretching is because it takes a little longer to get the muscle tissue really worked out of there. So foam rolling, the main beneficial thing for it is it promotes blood flow to repair muscles, all that sort of stuff. So it takes a little bit longer to get it going. First up, we'll do quads. That's just simply laying on the foam roller itself, and you'll just be rolling yourself back and forth, fully supported on your quads. You can lessen the pressure by lifting yourself up on your elbows here, or you can put more pressure by simply letting go as well. Really try and focus on full range. Don't try and focus on one spot on the quads. Move up and down the whole entire length. Good. Next up will be the IT bands. So that's going to be the area running down the side of your quad. We'll do one at a time, 45 seconds each. This one does tend to hurt a little bit more as it's a very tight band of muscle that a lot of people don't stretch and can tighten up pretty easily. So Really try and focus on moving up and down the full length, using your back leg here as well. You can lift yourself up to loosen the pressure a bit if it's a little too much for you. Always take a little 5 second break if you need to as well. Good, and switch sides. Purpose of this, we'll do a side view. Feel that pain releasing from your body. Good. Back up. Third one will be the hip. So we'll focus on the side of the hip itself. You're going to be slightly slanted on the roller, going back and forth on that front hip muscle. You can always lean a little bit to the side as well, hit a different angle, a little more on the front side, focusing in on that hip muscle. Remember, these are 45 seconds each for the purpose of really getting into the muscle group itself, wanting the blood flow to promote recovery. Good, and switch sides. Good. Fourth exercise will be the glutes. Put the foam roller behind you. Focus on one side at a time. Sit on the foam roller, slightly slanted to the side, and roll all the way up and down your glutes. On 10 more seconds. And switch sides. Okay, and down. Next up will be the hamstrings. So we'll bring the roller back out in front of us here, and we can do both at the same time as well. Get up on it and stretch, roll back and forth. Remember, it's okay to stop, reset sometimes. The roller can get out either in front of you or behind you. Just make sure it's still going up and down, full range of the muscle. Good. Next up, we'll focus on the calf muscles, and we can do these at the same time as well. So just roll them down your leg, supporting on your hands behind you, rolling back and forth. You can twist it to the side, hit the insides a little more if you twist it to the insides. All the way up and down your calf muscle. Feel the release of that pressure, the tightness leaving your body. Five more seconds. All right. Next up will be our upper back or shoulder area. So you're gonna put the foam roller back behind you, lean down on it, put your hands behind your head, and roll back and forth, upper back and shoulder area. Remember to keep breathing in and out. If you feel a few back cracks, that's okay. Should be doing that and releasing pressure. And if you'd like even more stretch, pull your chin to your chest or your chest by pushing your hands on the back of your head. Definitely one of my favorite ones. Last but not least, we'll lower back, focus on our lower back here, so bring the roller down. You don't have to have your hands behind your head for this one. Just rolling it back and forth, especially on that muscle going on either side of your spine, tends to be tight on a lot of people. So you can lean to one side, focus on that side of the spine, and then lean to the other as well, and focus on that side. Keep it going. Okay. Put the foam roller away now. The last part of our session, we'll focus on dowel stretches. So grab your thin piece of tubing, dowel, whatever you want to call it. We'll stand up for these. Stretch out my mat. First exercise we'll be doing is shoulder circles. So standing up nice and tall, firm grip, bringing it behind your head. Go 30 seconds this way and switch to the other way. You're almost doing a figure eight. Switch directions. Should feel that nice shoulder stretch. All right. Next up will be a T-spine stretch. So you'll have your two right out in front of you like so. Grasp the top and just lean into it. Neutral spine, you should feel that stretching all the way up your spine, all the way up the back. Really trying to lean into the ground. Hold the position, focus on breathing. Good, and up tall, shake it out. Next one we have is a shoulder dislocate workout. Not as bad as it sounds, I promise, it's just the name of it. So what we'll do is we'll up on top of a straight arm, firm grasp, bring it behind your body, hold for a few seconds, and then back up, reset, bringing it behind your body, a few seconds, up, reset. Should feel that coming right through your shoulders. Remember to keep your arms as straight as you can behind you. Back up, do a couple more. Behind your body, straight arm, hold. Feels good. Back up. One more time. Hold the position. And back up. Shake it out. Got two more exercises. Do each one of the side leans coming up next for 30 seconds. So again, firm grasp, pop your head, leaning to one side. Remember to keep your arms as straight as you can. And you're just gonna lean to one side. Hold the position. Other side. Should feel that right down on the side and as well as your lower back if it's tight. Ten more seconds. Alright, and we're back up. Last exercise will be a thoracic. So this one will be down in front of you, slight lean forward, switch to one side. Really trying to focus on bringing this bottom arm especially over. Switch sides. And to add a little flair to this one, we can add in a movement as well. All right. So that does it for our flexibility session today. Just to go over what we did a short warm-up. We did static stretching, 11 exercises total. Then we went into foam rolling, did 8 exercises total. And then finally into the dowel stretches for a total of 5. Our goal today was to really try and either bolster your current stretching routine or add some new things into it, give you some new fresh ideas, or simply just a good thing to do in the morning or before bed. We encourage you to do the CF98 form if you sustained an injury in today's session. And again, we always thank you for watching our videos, participating. We encourage you to subscribe to stay up to date on new videos, new workouts, and new sessions.